There are other important aspects of this phenomenon, which I think bears discussion, because it has serious impact on the field of the fundamental biology of aging and why it has been virtually ignored as a legitimate area for research. Another instance that comes to mind in respect to the status of the causes of death is Alzheimer's disease, a disease that was barely recognized 30 years ago, and through a series of very interesting events, mostly marketing events, certainly in the United States, by the Alzheimer's Disease Association, it has become a foremost in the minds of many people as a worry. Not that that's incorrect. It is a serious disease, but it in fact affects caregivers to Alzheimer's disease patients more than it affects the patients themselves, who are usually in such a cognitive state that they're unaware of their mental problem, but physically they continue to remain usually in a healthy state, which doesn't surprise me when I first read a paper submitted to the journal called Experimental Gerontology, of which I was editor-in-chief for 13 years. A paper came in from statisticians in Canada who reported that compared to an equivalent number of people without Alzheimer's disease and who were who were physically healthy as the Alzheimer's disease patients were also, other than their cognitive incapabilities, that the Alzheimer's disease patients actually lived longer than the normal controls. Their suspicion was that this could be attributed to the better care that they had, because Alzheimer's disease patients usually have very good care, either by their families or by caregivers. So that concept is important to be understood.